Back now with Today Property Watch. And inner suburbs in our nation's largest cities are finding themselves in the grips of a property market downturn as rising interest rates push prices lower.
And to discuss this all, we're joined by Domain Property Editor Alice Stoltz in Melbourne. Alice, great to have your company, as we do most Saturdays. It all comes down to supply and demand. Is that what's driving this?
Good morning, guys. That's right. And it's supply and demand, and we don't have much of it at the moment. Interest rates are really hitting prices hard. Data out by PID this week talked around where we're seeing downturns and upturns in the market, and Melbourne and Sydney are certainly leading that charge. Brisbane is also coming off. Even Adelaide, which has long been the country's strongest market, is also taking a hit to what's happening with prices and also the amount of stock on the market.
Let's talk auction clearance rates. What are we seeing this week?
Clearance rates are an interesting one at the moment. We're certainly seeing them dip down around the country at the moment. Basically, in Sydney, it's improved slightly but continues to see a decline year on year and now sitting at 52%. Melbourne's clearance rates are the biggest increase out of the capitals this week, but is only down at 54%. And Adelaide, once again, is at 69%, the strongest of any clearance rate in the country. Now, in terms of the auction numbers this weekend, these are down across all capital cities this week. Now, if we step back a bit, this means auction volumes have now fallen for the third consecutive month across the combined capitals. And obviously, we are in winter, people do list less, but we definitely are tracking annually down on what we were this time last year.
We always like a sticky beak at the most expensive home sold this week. What was it this week?
It sold for a cool just over $13 million in Wurrunga in Sydney, and it's a six-bedroom, four-bathroom home with a championship-sized tennis court, like a court I've never seen anything like this one before. Swimming pool, spa, and you can see a very distinctive sort of Parisian-style interior and fitting. So quite an incredible house, and obviously in Sydney proper. So those houses are really commanding those high prices, going for just over $13 million. On to the most affordable now, and this is down in Narragan in WA, which is just 200 kilometres southeast of Perth. It sold for $119,000. It's a three-bedroom, one-bathroom house. Now, the thing about this property is it's currently leased out. So if you're looking at rent vesting or looking at having some extra income come in, if you want a house for $119,000, knowing there's a tenant in there that will help contribute to that mortgage, it's probably not a bad option for you at the moment.
This last one, you were calling it the OMG house. Tell us more about this.
It is an OMG house. If you've ever wondered why Castle Cove on Sydney's North Shore is named as such, it is because of this incredible castle. It's set on over 8,000 square metres, and it was built by a local politician at the time in 1904. And, I mean, how often do we see houses like this? It's eight-bedroom, four-bathroom. It comes with guest quarters, of course, for your domestic staff. Tennis court, amazing Gothic-style interiors, and truly has some of the most incredible views over Sydney Harbour as well.
And turrets, which are important if the Normans
every
attack.
Every house needs a turret, don't they?
It's very helpful.
Their home is their castle.
Apparently. Very good. Alice, we appreciate it.
Thanks Alice. Guys.